FlyBase video tutorial, RNA-Seq series, part 3, searching for similarly expressed genes. Before we use the RNA-Seq similarity search tool, we want to briefly revisit RNA-Seq data in GBrowse. To navigate to the GBrowse view shown here, we have entered the coordinates of the region of interest in the landmark or region box. We have selected three tracks in the Select Tracks tab to view several genes, their annotated transcripts, and RNA-Seq data for the mode-encode developmental stages of this region. By mousing over the RNA-Seq top view, a pop-up will appear that enumerates the stages or tissues represented. Note that the last six tracks for adults are specified by sex as well as by stage. The view includes several genes with distinctive stage-specific patterns of expression. This becomes more apparent if the log2 default view is changed to a linear presentation using the spanner icon in the tier label. One of the configuration options is the signal scaling method, which we will change to linear, and then click on Apply Changes. The gamma tubulin gene is particularly interesting. It is highly expressed in adult females and early embryos, a pattern that is frequently seen for genes required during the earliest events of embryogenesis. So, a question that might be asked is, are there other tubulins with this type of expression pattern? The FlyBase RNA-Seq similarity search, which we will access via the gamma tubulin gene page, allows such a query. From this GBrowse page, move to the gamma tubulin 37C gene page by clicking on the blue gene span arrow. Once on the gene page, scroll down and open the section labeled Expression Data, and then High Throughput Expression Data. In the Associated Tools section are links to other RNA-Seq browsers and tools. The reference here explains the algorithm used to calculate the quantitative representations of RNA-Seq levels by gene that we will be showing next. To find genes with a similar developmental pattern of expression, open the section called Mode-encode Developmental RNA-Seq. This is a graphical representation of RNA-Seq levels, expressed in RPKM using the same data represented in the GBrowse view. RPKM stands for reads of transcript per kilobase per million mapped reads. Please click on this link if you wish to find out more about RPKM calculation in FlyBase. The average RPKM values of the gene are calculated for each of the represented developmental stages. As we saw on the GBrowse view, gamma tubulin 37C is very highly expressed in 0 to 2 hours embryos, and highly expressed in adult females, with low to undetectable expression in other stages. At the top of the view is a box Search for similarly expressed genes. Clicking on this box brings up a hit list with information about genes with similar expression patterns, as well as a correlation score and a visual representation of the expression profile for each gene. In the biological process go column, many processes involved in the earliest events of embryogenesis appear. By scrolling down a bit, the gene alpha tubulin 67C is found, answering the question concerning other tubulins with this expression pattern. Clicking on that gene and viewing the RNA-Seq quantitative data for the mode-encode developmental stages shows a virtually identical pattern of expression. Returning to the similar pattern hit list, note that genes with lower correlation scores have patterns that are less similar. This RNA-Seq by gene data can be downloaded as a tab-separated file, TSV, and are also available as a bulk data download. The RNA-Seq similarity search can also be accessed via the RNA-Seq button on the homepage. After you specify the gene of interest, this search interface allows the option of using a subset of samples within a dataset, such as a subset of stages or tissues. This completes our third tutorial on RNA-Seq data in FlyBase.